Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Swedish ebook before it's gone.
In this video, you learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Swedish. Hi everybody, my name is Emma. Welcome to the 800 Core Swedish Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Swedish. But there's a twist, which each new lesson in this series will include the previous lessons at the end. So after you learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at SwedishPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally master Swedish. Okay, let's get started. First is hey. Hello. Hey. Hey. Hello. Människorna sa det hej. The people said hello. Människorna sa det hej. Ursäkta mig. Excuse me. Ursäkta mig. Ursäkta mig. Excuse me. Ursäkta mig, vilken är nästa? Excuse me, which is next? Ursäkta mig, vilken är nästa? Jag är ledsen. I'm sorry. Jag är ledsen. Jag är ledsen. I'm sorry. Jag är ledsen, men jag har en fråga. I am sorry, but I have a question. Jag är ledsen. Jag är ledsen, men jag har en fråga. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Vi hörs snart. Good night. I talk to you soon. Good night. Vi hörs snart. Trevligt att träffas. Nice to meet you. Trevligt att träffas. Trevligt att träffas. Nice to meet you. Det är alltid trevligt att träffa dig. It's always nice to meet you. Det är alltid trevligt att träffa dig. Hur mår du? How are you? Hur mår du? Hur mår du? How are you? Hej, hur mår du? Hello, how are you? Hej, hur mår du? Ja. Yes. Ja. Ja. Yes. Ja, det gör jag. Yes, I do. Ja. Det gör jag. Nej. No. Nej. Nej. No. Nej. Hon är en ingenjör. No. She's an engineer. Nej. Hon är en ingenjör. Tack. Thank you. Tack. Tack. Thank you. Det är bara bra, tack. It's just fine, thank you. Det är bara bra, tack. Jag heter. I'm. Jag heter. Jag heter. I'm. Jag heter Alexandra. I am Alexandra. Jag heter Alexandra. Hej då. Goodbye. Hej då. Hej då. Goodbye. Hej då. Ha det så bra. Goodbye. Take care. Hej då. Ha det så bra. Dålig. Bad. Dålig. Dålig. bad. Maten är dålig. The food is bad. Maten är dålig. Bra. Good. Bra. Bra. Good. Grönsaker är bra för dig. Vegetables are good for you. Grönsaker är bra för dig. Söt. Pretty. Söt. Söt. Pretty. Din klänning är söt. Your dress is very pretty. Din klänning är söt. Ful. Ugly. Ful. Ful. Ugly. Det där är en väldigt ful hund. That is a very ugly dog. Det där är en väldigt ful hund. Lätt. Easy. Lätt. Lätt. Easy. Jag vaknar väldigt lätt. I wake up very easily. Jag vaknar väldigt lätt. Svår. Difficult. Svår. Svår. Difficult. Provet på onsdag kommer att vara svårt. Wednesday's test will be difficult. Provet på onsdag kommer att vara svårt. Nära. Near. Nära. Nära. Near. Jag bor nära universitetet. I live near the university. Jag bor nära universitetet. Långt. Far. Långt. Långt. Far. Stationen är långt härifrån. The station is far from here. Stationen är långt härifrån. Liten. Small. Liten. Liten. Small. Bilen är liten, men den är mycket kraftfull. The car is small, but it's very powerful. Bilen är liten, men den är mycket kraftfull. Well done! In this lesson, you expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at SwedishPod101.com. to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources. See you next time. Hejdå!
Can learning a new language help you make money? In this video, you'll learn three ways that learning a language can help increase your income. So if you know a language other than your native language, does it help you earn more money? Learning a new language provides a wide range of benefits, including personal growth, higher cognitive function, better resistance to age-related deterioration, and the opportunity to meet exciting new people from all over the world. But that's not all. It's possible that learning a foreign language can help you to earn more money throughout your life. Studies have shown that someone making $30,000 annually could boost their salary by at least $600 per year through applying their knowledge of another language. Over the course of a lifetime, that could add up to a significant contribution to your retirement savings or overall earnings. In this video, we're going to talk about how to get free language learning courses and tools that you can use for your studies, with the aim of boosting your income. One day, the extra money could possibly help you buy a new Ferrari, vacation home, or save more money for retirement. But first, let's look at a few ways you can make money with a second language. The first method is by exploring bilingual or multilingual job opportunities. With the rise of multinational corporations doing business all around the globe, the need for bilingual or even multilingual employees has never been higher. Therefore, knowing a second language can be extremely valuable. Having a second language as part of your skill set could help you make significantly more money than if you're fluent in just one language. So, in a very real way, learning a language online, even for free, can alter your career and earnings trajectory for the better, and it can help put you on the path towards the lifestyle you want. The second method is by exploring work you can do from home in your second language. It's possible to use your knowledge of a second language to work from home. There are many websites that have hundreds of paying translation jobs at any given time. Although the pay may vary significantly between jobs, and you probably won't actually become rich from such work, translation jobs can boost your salary and improve your lifestyle. And translation jobs aren't the only way to make money online from home. There are actually a wide range of opportunities out there for people to boost their income using their knowledge of a second language. These include copywriting, administrative work, and even multilingual IT jobs. The third method is by working overseas. If you love adventure or want to travel the world, you can put your language knowledge to use by taking advantage of bilingual or multilingual opportunities overseas. Put what you've learned to work in the real world. Combine your second language skills with the other skills you have and offer something special to employers. To start, think about a country where you might like to live someday and begin your language studies with the language spoken in that country. With diligent work, you can master a language and secure a position with an overseas company. These are just a few of the ways you can put your knowledge of another language to use and make some extra money with your skills. Over time, this added income can make a huge difference in your life. Our language learning program provides a number of free language learning tools and resources as part of our free lifetime account. You can use these to get started with your language learning and begin working toward boosting your income throughout your life. So, if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye! Today, traditional classrooms are no longer the only or even best place to learn a new language. More and more people are finding that they can easily learn a language just about anywhere they have a few minutes of spare time, including their daily commute to work. According to the US Census Bureau, the average American spends over 50 minutes a day commuting to and from work, or over 300 hours a year. But rather than simply sitting in traffic and wasting the time, you can instead use your daily commute to literally learn a new language in just a few short months. Our language learning program has specialized learning tools that you can use on your commute to and from the office to master a language in your spare time. What are some reasons traditional classroom settings just aren't the best option for most people in today's fast-paced world? Difficulty getting to and from class. Learning on someone else's schedule. Very expensive and may cost thousands of dollars to complete. Can take years to finally complete classes and learn the language. The simple truth is the traditional classroom instruction is simply not a viable option for most people in today's very fast-paced, time-starved world. Now, let's examine how you can learn a language faster, more easily, and at far less expense than traditional classes, all during your commute to work and back home again. Three reasons your daily commute can help you master a language in the next year. On average, Americans spend more than 300 hours per year commuting. During the commute to and from work, over 6 hours a week is completely wasted. The time isn't used to help you reach any goals or objectives. But thanks to online language learning platforms with audiobooks and other resources that you can access during your commute, you can easily transform wasted time into progress toward learning a new language. With over 300 hours available annually, your daily commute could provide you with enough time to gain significant skills in a new language each and every year. Increase your earning potential while commuting to work. How would you like to transform all those spare commuting hours each week into more money for a new car, house, or even a dream vacation? According to research, someone making $30,000 per year can boost their annual income by $600 or more per year by learning a second language. Over the course of a lifetime, that's a significant amount. How? From work-at-home translation jobs to working overseas, there are many ways to leverage your second language into more money in your bank account. So instead of wasting your precious time, you can make your commute more productive and eventually profitable. The more languages you learn, the higher your income potential. Repetition is key to mastering a new language. Not sure if it's practical to learn another language while commuting to and from work each day? Well, not only is it possible, learning in your car on the way to and from work each day can actually help you learn and master any language quickly. The simple truth is that repetition is absolutely vital to truly internalizing and mastering any language. So, if you listen to audiobooks or even audio lessons on your commute to work, and then repeat the same lesson on your commute home, the information is more likely to be locked into your long-term memory. Our language learning program has been helping people learn and master language in the comfort of their home, during their daily commute, or any place they have a few spare minutes of time. Here are five features of our program that make it easy to learn a new language while commuting to and from work. First, the largest collection of audio lessons on the planet by native speaker instructors. Every single week, native speaker instructors create new audio lessons. All lessons are short, to the point, and guaranteed to improve your mastery of a language. Second, the word of the day. Simply exposing yourself to new information and vocabulary terms helps increase your fluency and mastery of your target language. So every single day, check out the word of the day and memorize it during your commute. It's a quick and easy way to boost your vocabulary every day. Third, daily dose mini lessons. Have a short commute to work but still want to make progress towards learning more than just vocabulary? Not a problem. Our daily dose mini lessons are 1 minute or less and are designed to improve your grammar, conversations, and pronunciation. Fourth, all content is available on a convenient mobile app. You don't need a PC or tablet to learn during your daily commute. Instead, all of our lessons, tools, and resources are available 24/7 via our mobile app. That means you can access all of our audio lessons and other tools during your commute to work or anytime you have a few spare minutes. Fifth, audiobooks and other supplemental resources. In addition to the world's largest online collection of HD audio lessons, our language learning program has audiobooks to enhance your understanding and make it more convenient than ever to learn a language during your commute. The average commute time of most Americans is over 300 hours each year, and it's the perfect opportunity to learn and master a new language. Use the dead time during your daily commute to learn a new language and potentially boost your lifetime earnings. Whatever your motivation, our language learning program has the tools and resources necessary to help you learn a new language each year during your commute to and from work. So, if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye!
In this video, you learned 20 of the most common words and phrases in Swedish. Hi everybody, my name is Emma. Welcome to the 800 Core Swedish Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Swedish. But there's a twist, which each new lesson in this series will include the previous lessons at the end. So after you learned the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at SwedishPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally master Swedish. Okay, let's get started. First is idag. Today. Idag. Idag. Today. Hon ser väldigt ledsen ut idag. She looks really sad today. Hon ser väldigt ledsen ut idag. Igår. Yesterday. Igår. Igår. Yesterday. Jag tog en dag ledigt igår. I took a day off yesterday. Jag tog en dag ledigt igår. Imorgon, tomorrow, imorgon, imorgon. Tomorrow. Imorgon är det min födelsedag. Tomorrow is my birthday. Imorgon är det min födelsedag. Vecka. Week. Vecka. Vecka. Week. Det är 7 dagar på en vecka. There are 7 days in a week. Det är 7 dagar på en vecka. År. Year. År. År. Year. Ett kalenderår. One calendar year. Ett kalenderår. Sekund. Second. Sekund. Sekund. Second. Det är 58 sekunder kvar på stoppuret. There are 58 seconds left on the stopwatch. Det är 58 sekunder kvar på stoppuret. Minut. Minute. Minut. Minut. Minute. Det är en minut till midnatt. It's 1 minute to midnight. Det är en minut till midnatt. Timme. Hour. Timme. Timme. Hour. Jag kommer hem från jobbet om en timme. I'll be home from work in an hour. Jag kommer hem från jobbet om en timme. Klocka. Klock. Klocka. Klocka. Klock. Väggklockan hänger på väggen. The wall clock is hanging on the wall. Väggklockan hänger på väggen. Klockan. A clock. Klockan. Klockan. A clock. Dina vänner kom klockan 7. Your friends came at 7 o'clock. Dina vänner kom klockan 7. Kalender. 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 Jag markerade vår årsdag i kalendern. I marked our anniversary on the calendar. Jag markerade vår årsdag i kalendern. Måndag. Monday. Måndag. Måndag. Monday. Arbetsveckan börjar på måndag. The work week starts on Monday. Arbetsveckan börjar på måndag. Tisdag. Tuesday. Tisdag. Tisdag. Tuesday. 1 januari infaller på en tisdag i år. January 1st falls on a Tuesday this year. 1 januari infaller på en tisdag i år. Onsdag. Wednesday. Onsdag. Onsdag. Wednesday. Vi spelar poker hos mig på onsdagarskvällar. Wednesday nights we play poker at my house. Vi spelar poker hos mig på onsdagarskvällar. Torsdag. Thursday. Torsdag. Torsdag. Thursday. Imorgon är det onsdag och i övermorgon är det torsdag. Tomorrow is Wednesday and the day after tomorrow is Thursday. Imorgon är det onsdag. Och i övermorgon är det torsdag. Fredag. Friday. Fredag. Fredag. Friday. Skriv ner planerna för fredag i kalendern. Write the plans for Friday on the calendar. Skriv ner planerna för fredag i kalendern. Lördag. Saturday. Lördag. Lördag. Saturday. Jag gör hushållsarbete i 5 timmar varje lördag. I do housework every Saturday for 5 hours. Jag gör hushållsarbete i 5 timmar varje lördag. Söndag. Sunday. Söndag. Söndag. Sunday. Det är fars dag på söndag. Sunday is Father's Day. Det är fars dag på söndag. Göra. Do. Göra. Göra. Do. Jag har så mycket jobb att göra. I have so much work to do. Jag har så mycket jobb att göra. Gå. Go. Gå. Gå. Go. Gå till parken. Go to the park. Gå till parken. Well done. In this lesson, you expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at SwedishPod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources. See you next time. Hejdå!
What are the best ways to learn a language on the go? You might be surprised to find there are lots of moments throughout the day we can transform into language learning opportunities. These might be on your commute, during an exercise session, or even just when you're trying to kill some time. In this video, we'll introduce you to 3 tips for learning on the go. Number 1, how to learn a language on the go. Many of us are probably used to studying when we have time to sit down and concentrate. We take out textbooks and notepads and prepare to focus our attention for an hour or so, like in a classroom. It might be hard to think of studying in other settings, like when you're sitting on a bus or are stuck in traffic, but there are still things you can do, even if your hands are full. For example, think about your commute. How much time do you spend traveling to and from work, school, or other activities throughout the week? If you have a 1-hour commute every day, that's a lot of time you could be spending working on your language skills. Even if you're not ready to devote your whole commute to study, a little bit every day will help. But how do you study in environments like these? By changing the way you approach your learning. These days, many people now have a computer right in their pocket. Smartphones make it easy to access many different kinds of study materials. Depending on our needs and the time we have available, we can watch YouTube videos, listen to podcasts, study vocabulary, review infographics, and more. There are many different ways to build our language skills, and we can choose study methods that work for our schedules, our personalities, and our goals. There are a lot of different methods to consider. So in part 2, we're going to share a few ideas to help you get started. Number 2, 5 easy ways to learn a language on the go. If you're standing on a crowded train, you can't pull out a book or do workbook problems. If you're exercising, it's probably impossible to review textbooks or take notes. If you're driving, you need to make sure you're watching the road. So how do you transform times like these into study opportunities? Situations like these are great for audio and video lessons. We have huge libraries of both, so you can choose whichever is best for you. All you need to study is a smartphone, a lesson, and a pair of earphones. Just press play and watch a video or listen to an audio lesson, like you would with music. During your commute or exercise session, you'll hear a simple conversation focused on a specific goal, like introducing yourself or ordering food. Then, our teachers will explain the words and phrases. In just a few minutes, you'll be working on mastering an entire conversation. Our second study method suggestion is our app, Innovative Language 101. You can download it for free for the iPhone, iPad, and Android. This will allow you to take your lessons with you wherever you go. Study idea 3 is for those of you who want something super quick and easy. You can use it to kick off your studies each day. It's our Word of the Day email. Every day, you get an email with a new word, example sentences, audio, and a picture to help make it stick in your mind. If you check your email during your commute, you can also check the word of the day. Our last two study method ideas are about tools that can help you remember what you study. First is our vocab slideshow tool. This study tool is available on all vocab lists and lessons. Just press play and listen to words and phrases one by one. You can even set the slideshow on a loop and listen to the words over and over. Finally, our last suggestion is our smart flashcards. These flashcards use spaced repetition to help you study and remember words, and the cards are mobile friendly. The cards remember your progress and quiz you on words at the right times. This helps ensure you don't forget the things you study. To access these, visit the site on your phone and find the flashcards in the vocabulary menu. Swipe through as you study. Our system will remember your progress. If you get a word wrong, you'll see it more often. The flashcards know to quiz you again and again until you remember that word. Number 3, be consistent. If you can find new ways to use your time and work towards your language goals, great. But remember to be consistent. Using all or even part of your commute or your downtime to study can be a fantastic way to make progress, but you need to make sure to do it regularly. Try to build a habit of starting a video lesson as soon as your commute begins, or pressing play on an audio lesson as soon as you begin a jog. Creating these habits will help you stick with your study methods long term and will lead to greater progress. For the tools we've talked about in this video and much more, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye. Being in planes, trains, and buses can be an uncomfortable experience for many people. Often there are small, cramped seats, not many things to do, and sometimes the experience is even scary. Despite this, you often see people working in these environments. How do they do it? In this video, you'll learn 3 tips to help you be able to study anywhere. The first one is, adjust to your environment. Most of us would probably agree that a plane or a bus is not the best place to study. These environments are usually dark and cramped, and you may have a crying baby next to you. But the point is, there's never a perfect time or place to learn. The reality is that a lot of us use transportation every day. We face environments that are typically considered unsuitable for study. Trains get crowded. You can't do much in your car. Even in your own home, you'll get distracted by the TV or Facebook or something. And some days you'll be sick. You'll be tired. You'll have dinner plans. Once you accept that there's rarely such a thing as the perfect time to study, you can start thinking about how to make the best of the environment you have at that time. For example, if you ride a train, you might stand up for a long time. It might be difficult to focus on a book. In a case like this, you can use the Innovative Language 101 app to study, listen to the audio lessons, or do the word of the day by email. There are ways that you can learn in just about any situation. The point is, you need to adjust your study method to your environment. So take a look at your day and see where your time goes. Are there any gaps in between your activities where you feel like you can't study? And is there any way you can adjust? 2, take advantage of your limited time. We've surveyed tons of learners over the years, and every year we find that the number one reason most people don't learn a language is they say they have no time. But there's a chance you may have some spare time to study. You might just not recognize it yet. Let's say you commute for 30 minutes every day. You can ask yourself, how do I put these next 30 minutes to use? Or if you finish work at 7 p.m. and spend an hour doing nothing, you can think about what you might do in that hour that will help you work towards your goals. You don't have to use all 30 minutes of your commute or the full hour of your free time, but you can definitely fit in a short lesson or take other steps towards your goals. 3, have an on and off mindset. When you work, it can be really helpful to have a kind of on-off switch for when it's time to work and time to rest. You can apply the same idea to your language studies. When it's time to study, you can focus solely on that. You don't spend time thinking about doing it, you just do it. It doesn't matter where you are or what kind of studying you're doing, as long as it gets done. And when you're done with a lesson, reward yourself. It can be as simple as telling yourself, "Great job!" When you're finished with the time you promised yourself for studies, feel free to focus on the next thing. In this video, we covered a few tips to help you study no matter where you are or how much time you have. It's all about having the right mindset. And for even more ways to study, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
In this video, you learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Swedish. Hi everybody, my name is Emma. Welcome to the 800 Core Swedish Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Swedish. But there's a twist, which each new lesson in this series will include the previous lesson at the end. So after you learn the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at SwedishPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally master Swedish. Okay, let's get started. First is kan, can, kan, kan, can. Jag kan äta stark mat. I can eat spicy food. Jag kan äta stark mat. Noll, zero, noll, noll, zero. Det är runt 0 grader idag. It's about 0 degrees today. Det är runt 0 grader idag. Ett, one, ett, ett, one. Det går 24 timmar på ett dygn. There are 24 hours in one day. Det går 24 timmar på ett dygn. Två, two, två, två, two. Nummer två är mitt favoritnummer. The number two is my favorite number. Nummer två är mitt favoritnummer. Tre. Three. Tre. Tre. Three. Nummer tre. Number three. Nummer tre. Fyra. Four. Fyra. Fyra. Four. Fyrfilig motorväg. Four lane motorway. Fyrfilig motorväg. Fem, five, fem, fem, five. Sjöstjärnan har fem ben. The starfish has five legs. Sjöstjärnan har fem ben. six, 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 six saker, six things, six saker, sju, seven, sju, sju, seven, sju grader, 7 degrees, sju grader, åtta, eight, åtta, åtta, eight. Du bör sova minst 8 timmar varje natt. You should sleep at least 8 hours every night. Du bör sova minst 8 timmar varje natt. 9. 9. 9. 9. 9. 99%. 99%. 99%. 10. 10. 10. 10. 10. Jag kan räkna från 1 till 10 på kinesiska. I can count from 1 to 10 in Chinese. Jag kan räkna från 1 till 10 på kinesiska. Försäljare. Salesman. Försäljare. Försäljare. Salesman. Försäljaren hälsar på en kund. The salesman is greeting a customer. Försäljaren hälsar på en kund. Chef. Manager. Chef. Chef. Manager. Fabrikschefen ger instruktioner. The factory manager is giving instructions. Fabrikschefen ger instruktioner. Kock. Cook. Kock. Kock. Cook. Hon är en kock på en 4-stjärnig restaurang. She's a cook at a 4-star restaurant. Hon är kock på en 4-stjärnig restaurang. Ingenjör. Engineer. Ingenjör. Ingenjör. Engineer. En bra ingenjör kan designa och bygga system. A good engineer can design and build systems. En bra ingenjör kan designa och bygga system. Programmerare. Programmer. Programmerare. Programmerare. Programmer. Jag är en programmerare. I am a programmer. Jag är en programmerare. Sjuksköterska. Nurse. Sjuksköterska. Sjuksköterska. Nurse. Kvinnan är en sjuksköterska. The woman is a nurse. Kvinnan är sjuksköterska. kropp, body, kropp, kropp, body. Mat är bensin för kroppen. Food is fuel for the body. Mat är bensin för kroppen. Huvud, head. Huvud, huvud. Head. Ha på dig en hjälm för att skydda huvudet. Wear a helmet to protect your head. Ha på dig en hjälm för att skydda huvudet. Well done! In this lesson, you expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at SwedishPod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You'll also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources. See you next time! Hejdå!
Most adults shy away from language learning for one obvious reason. Learning a language takes time. But just because you're busy doesn't mean you can't start learning a language. You just need the right tools that help you make the most of your limited time. How to learn easily for busy adults. And that's why in this guide, you'll discover 1. How to pick up practical conversations in just a few minutes a day. 2. How to boost your vocabulary for free. 3. Apps to use to learn on the go. And 4. The one self-made trap that stops most people, including busy adults, from learning. But first, if you don't yet have access to our language learning system, sign up for a free lifetime account right now. Just click the link in the description to get your free lifetime account. So, here's how you can start learning a language as a busy adult. And the first point is... the all-or-nothing mindset is when you think either you succeed or you fail, and there's no in-between. This kind of black-or-white thinking is common with perfectionists and those with high anxiety. And in the case of language learning, someone with this mindset will think, there's no point in learning for 10 or 15 minutes a day because it takes a lot of time. So either you go all out and study for hours a day, or you don't bother at all. And of course, the problem is nobody starts learning a language by going all out, just like nobody lifts 200 pounds on their first day at the gym. And even if you tried, you wouldn't last very long. Do you have this mindset? Leave us a comment. But before you start learning a language, try and change your mind about this, because it's much easier to stick with language as a habit and grow that habit if you're not overwhelming yourself from the start. Now, how can you learn if you're busy? If you're learning with our system, you get lessons by real teachers that are just 3 to 15 minutes in length. And in those few minutes you, 1. Hear a practical conversation, 2. Get every word and grammar rule explained, 3. Have the conversation repeated several times just to help it stick, 4. Learn cultural tips related to the lesson, and 5. You start speaking the language. So for those few minutes, you get the best possible return for the time you put in, which is great for busy adults. And after you're done with lesson number 1, we guide you to lesson 2 to 3, from absolute beginner all the way up to advanced. If you want to learn to speak the language without getting bogged down with grammar, then check out our Survival Phrases course. You'll learn basic conversations and phrases needed to survive in the country, like greetings, how to order food, how to ask for directions, and more. Again, lessons are just a few minutes long, and they're perfect for travelers, busy adults, and anyone looking for an easy start to the language. By the way, this 50-lesson Survival Phrases course is 100% free for all users until June 30th, so don't miss out on this freebie. It won't be available for long. Now, if you're always on the go and prefer using your phone, then download our app, Innovative Language Learning, for free. And this gives you the same access to all the lessons inside our system. That way, you can easily do a few lessons on your commute, on a break, or on a walk. The Word of the Day is a free service that sends you new words every day and improves your vocabulary. And you can easily spend a minute or two reading through the word, the examples, listening to the pronunciation, and saying it out loud. These are just a few ways you can start learning a language, even if you're low on time. So, if you want to learn the language and get access to these learning tools and our learning system, sign up for a free lifetime account right now. Just click the link in the description to get your free lifetime account. Remember, here's what you can do to learn all of these words by heart. Drill these words with our spaced repetition flashcards, which will help cement these words into your long-term memory. Save them to the Word Bank, your personal vocabulary collection, where you can print out your own study sheets, or review the words with our looped vocabulary slideshow, and play it until you know all of the words. So click the link in the description right now, and sign up for your free lifetime account to get these lessons and study tools.
In this video, you learn 20 of the most common words and phrases in Swedish. Hi everybody, my name is Emma. Welcome to the 800 Core Swedish Words and Phrases video series. This series will teach you the 800 most common words and phrases in Swedish. But there's a twist, which each new lesson in this series will include the previous lesson at the end. So after you learn the new words and phrases, stick around and review what you learned in previous lessons. Reviewing is one of the most important parts of learning a language. You can also get the full list right now at SwedishPod101.com. Click the link in the description to access more example sentences, create your own flashcard deck, and finally master Swedish. Okay, let's get started. First is hand. 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 Barnet räcker upp handen. The child is raising his hand. Barnet räcker upp handen. Arm, 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 arm. Vi gick armkrok på gatan. We walked arm in arm on the street. Vi gick armkrok på gatan. Fot, foot, 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 foot. En fot har fem tår. A foot has five toes. En fot har fem tår. Ben, leg, ben, ben, leg. Han ramlade och skrapade upp benet. He fell and grazed his leg. Han ramlade och skrapade upp benet. Finger. Finger, 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 finger. Mitt finger blöder. My fingers bleeding. Mitt finger blöder. Rygg, back. Rygg. Rygg. Back. En igelkotts rygg är täckt av vassa taggar. A hedgehog's back is covered in sharp spines. En igelkotts rygg är täckt av vassa taggar. Mage. Stomach. Mage. Mage. Stomach. Jag har magont. I have a stomachache. Jag har magont. Bröst. Chest. bröst, bröst, chest. Doktorn och sjuksköterskan röntgar patientens bröst. The doctor and nurse are taking an x-ray on the patient's chest. Doktorn och sjuksköterskan röntgar patientens bröst. Januari. January. Januari. Januari. January. Det är väldigt kallt här i januari. It's very cold here in January. Det är väldigt kallt här i januari. Februari. February. Februari. Februari. February. Februari är den kortaste månaden med 28 dagar. February is the shortest month with 28 days. Februari är den kortaste månaden med 28 dagar. Mars. March. Mars. Mars. March. Det är april nu, så förra månaden var mars. It's now April, so last month was March. Det är april nu, så förra månaden var mars. April. 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 April skurar bringer vårblommor. April showers bring May flowers. April skurar bringer vårblommor. Maj, May. Maj. Maj. May. 31 maj är den tobakosfria dagen. May 31st is World No Smoking Day. 31 maj är den tobakosfria dagen. Juni. June. Juni. Juni. June. Vi ska gifta oss i juni. We are getting married in June. Vi ska gifta oss i juni. Juli. July. Juli. Juli. July. Juli är namngift efter Julius Caesar som föddes i juli. July is named after Julius Caesar, who was born in July. Juli är namngett efter Julius Caesar som föddes i juli. Augusti, August, Augusti, Augusti, August. Skolan är stängd i augusti. The school is closed in August. Skolan är stängd i augusti. September. 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 Idag är det lördagen den 10 september. Today is Saturday, September 10th. Idag är det lördagen den 10 september. Oktober. 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 Den 30 oktober. On October 13th. Den 13 oktober. November. 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 November är en av fyra månader med 30 dagar. November is one of four months with 30 days. November är en av fyra månader med 30 dagar. December. 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 Nu är det december månad. Now it is the month of December. Nu är det december månad. Well done! In this lesson, you expanded your vocabulary and learned 20 new useful words. Click the link in the description and sign up for free at SwedishPod101.com to get access to the full list of vocabulary you need for daily life conversations. You'll also get example sentences, custom flashcard decks, and more learning resources. See you next time! Hej då!
Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Swedish ebook before it's gone.